Hello friends, welcome to Rapid Revision for Computer Science students. In this section of Mathematics, we will be discussing the matrices part 1 in detail. And in this video, we will be discussing the types of matrices. And then we will be heading on to the very useful results that are very important from the examination point of view. So let's get started. First is the types of matrices. The different types of matrices are square matrices where we will be discussing here. And so first one is diagonal matrix. So whatever the name suggests, it does opposite of that. From the name diagonal, you will be thinking that we will be restricting it and putting some condition on the diagonal elements, but it is not so. Rather, we will be discussing, we will be putting some of the restrictions on non-diagonal elements. So let's see and proceed to the formal definition of diagonal matrices. Diagonal matrices says that D is equals to A, it is a square matrices of n cross n order where Aij, that is elements, are 0 if it is not diagonal. Okay, for all I is not equals to J. So how I is not equals to J, let's see. For a normal general matrix, if we see A11, A12, A13, n cross 3 cross 3 we are taking A22 and A23 where Aij is the ith row and jth column. So this is a normal general matrix of 3 cross 3 order, and here we are saying that we have to put that wherever I is not equals to J. So let's take first of all whatever I equals J. Here I equals J, that is 1 1, here I equals J 2 2, here also 3 3, so I equals J. So whatever the non-diagonal elements are there, we have to put them 0. So let's put them 0. So we are eliminating them and putting them 0 instead of anything. That must be 0, okay? Diagonal elements may be anything, non-zero value or zero value. We don't bother, but we are bothered about the non-diagonal elements must be 0. For example, if we take 1, 2, 3 as a diagonal and rest must be zeros. And we can also take another example, while diagonal elements are 0, but all non-diagonal elements must also be 0. Now our next matrix is upper triangular matrix. Here also whatever the name suggests, it does opposite of that. It puts condition on lower triangle rather than the upper triangle, opposite to the meaning of the name. Okay, so what does it tell? That whatever the lower triangle is there, lower triangle must be 0. And otherwise anything can be anything, but the lower triangle must be 0. So if we take a general matrix, that is A11, A12, A13. A21, A22, A23, A31, A32 and A33. Suppose this is a matrix, standard matrix. If we see the lower triangle, this is lower triangle, we will see a pattern that here I part, that is 2, is greater than 1. Here 3 is greater than 1 and here 3 is greater than 2. So we can see that here I is greater than J. So we will define it as suppose it is a kind of, it is a matrix, square matrix Aij of n cross n, where Aij is equals to 0 for all I is greater than J. That is, we have to put here zeros where I is greater than J. So this is what known as upper triangular matrix. So we are putting condition on the lower triangle rather than the upper triangle. Now our third matrix is lower triangular matrix. In lower triangular matrix, same is the case, that is, it tells the reverse the meaning of what it says, that it says that the upper triangle must be 0. Okay, so let's see in a general matrix, A11, A12, A13, A21, A22. A23, A31, A32 and A33. So what we are saying, that upper triangle must be 0. So this is our upper triangle, and this is diagonal, and this is our upper triangle. So here we also see some pattern, like here I is less than j. 1 is less than 3, 1, 2 is less than 3. So I is less than j. Here we saw the pattern, I is less than j. So we'll define a lower triangular matrix, like it is a square matrix of n cross n order, where aij is equals to 0 for all I is less than j. This is our condition. So just where I is less than j, just remove them, and instead of them, just you have to put 0. And other can be anything, 0 or non-zero. So this is the lower triangular matrix. Then after that we will be discussing the identity matrix and invertible matrix. Identity matrix we are doing since our childhood. Okay, so you must be remembering, but still that must also be crystal clear. You should not have doubt in anywhere, otherwise you will not be able to solve the questions. So identity matrix, here IN is equals to AIJ n cross n, where we know that the diagonal elements must be 1 and non-diagonal elements must be 0. So suppose this is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, and A33. So here we know that diagonal elements must be 1. Okay, so diagonal elements, we observe the pattern that I equals j. So where aij is equals to 1 if I is equals to j, and 0 if I is not equals to j. So where I equals j is here. So here you have to put 1. So here we are putting 1s. And wherever I is not equals to j, the rest are all where I is not equals to j. So we are removing them. And instead of them, we are putting zeros. So we are putting zeros. So this is our identity matrix of 3 cross 3 order. So similarly, for 1 cross 1 order, I1 will be 1 itself, I2 will be 1, 1 on the diagonal and 0 on the non-diagonal. So this is the identity matrix. Then it is very important if you want to find the inverse and do many calculations, it is very important. So let's get on to the next one. Next, that is also very important, that is invertible matrix. Invertible matrix, as the name suggests, is a matrix that has its inverse. It is also known as non-singular matrix. Non-singular matrix, okay. So you can see here that it is non-singular matrix, and it is invertible, is known as non-singular matrix whose inverse exists. So let's define it formally. An cross n is invertible if AB is equals to BA is equals to identity matrix of n cross n order for some B n cross n. You have to remember that the order of this matrix, A matrix, must be same as this of B matrix, and identity matrix is also of the same order. Obviously, the multiplication result in the same order. We write B is equals to A inverse. That is, the inverse of A is B. Otherwise, if it does not exist, A is non-invertible, or we can say singular matrix. Okay, so that is all for the types of matrices. So let's discuss some of the very important results that will be helpful in doing from the numerical problems. Okay, so first is A inverse inverse is equals to A, that is, you are doing 2 times inverse, you are getting the back the same thing. If K A, that is constant, is multiplied to the matrix and inverse is done, then it will be 1 by K A inverse. Third property says A B inverse is equals to B inverse A inverse. It is similar kind of a shoe socks problem. Yes, you heard it right. Suppose you are wearing shoes, socks first, and then you wear shoes. And while at the time of removal, you pop out your socks first, and then you are popping out your socks. So this is a kind of shoe socks problem. You can correlate with this. So it will be very easy if you correlate. So AB whole inverse is equals to B inverse A inverse. And fourth one is similar. We are extending this concept only. Okay, so it is C inverse B inverse A inverse. Now fifth point says IN inverse, that's the identity inverse, is equals to identity matrix itself. And note that A plus B inverse is not equals to B inverse plus A inverse. Okay, so this is not like that. Okay, this is invalid. So you have to remember that here A dot B, that is AB inverse, is there, not A plus B inverse. So everything I told you about types of matrices and results, I hope it is clear to you. If any doubt is there, please write on the comment section. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. So please like, comment and subscribe. Bye for now. Thank you.